Christmas village wreath for our Christmas decorations. Hey guys, welcome back to Home Cuts. My name is Priya and today we are going to make this cute Christmas village wreath for our Christmas decorations. For this Christmas village wreath, we are using an old pine cone wreath base which was created last year for Christmas, this garland, these tiny houses, some tinsel trees and some berries. For our first step, we are wrapping this tinsel garland around our pine cones to give it a full Christmas vibe look. Next, we are going to glue a piece of styrofoam on the base of the wreath. This will provide a stable structure to add your houses and trees for the Christmas village. Once you have the styrofoam in place, add some more garland to cover it up nicely. This way you further secure the styrofoam in place and hide some rough finishes. Once you have a stable structure for your village, it's time to add some string lighting. You can fill the entire field base or just add where you are going to add your trees and houses. We are going to glue our houses and trees onto this styrofoam base. Now add berries for some color contrast. These red berries will look great with this green and white color combination and ooze the Christmas vibe. And there you go. Your Christmas village wreath is all ready to adorn your home. Ornament wreath for our Christmas decorations. For this Christmas ornament wreath, you only need a wreath base, some ornaments and some green tinsel. For our first step, we are going to wrap the tinsel around the wreath and then we will glue our ornaments to it. Once the garland is in place, it's time to glue the ornaments onto the wreath. You can color coordinate or randomly attach them on the wreath base. Christmas wreath from burlap ribbons. For our rustic burlap Christmas wreath, we are using a grapevine wreath base, some burlap ribbons, red ribbon bows, plaid green ribbon bow, and some of these ornaments. For our first step, we are gluing the burlap ribbon on our wreath base while twisting it on some points. Once the twisting of the ribbon is done, make sure that the ribbon is glued properly. Once the burlap ribbon is in place, we are going to add our bows and ornaments. Now I have silver, red and golden berries, but I think the gold will give off a more beautiful contrast with the red, so I'm using these. Add the big festive bow on top. Glue it down properly. And use the smaller red ones on sides. Cute poinsettia wreath for Christmas decorations. For our poinsettia wreath, we are using a grapevine wreath base, some poinsettia flowers, plaid ribbon, golden berries, and some green garland. For the first step, we are wrapping the green garland around our wreath base. Simply just coil it around. Don't worry about tucking it in or pinning it down. It will hold. Make sure to leave place for the hanging twine. You can completely cover the wreath base or leave some space to insert the flowers. I'm partially covering it up, and then I'm going to stick the flowers in these gaps. Moving on to the next step, we are going to insert our poinsettia flowers into these little gaps in our wreath base. You won't have to worry about gluing them down and ruining the flowers. You can use them next year as well. You don't have to be symmetrical, you can just go with your gut and add them wherever you feel like it. Just make sure that they are secured in place so they don't fall down when you hang the wreath. Also make sure that you leave some space for your ribbon at the bottom. And for other stuff that you might be using, I am using golden berry. Shake it once to see if any flowers are loose. Now we are going to insert our berries. Just find any gaps and put them in there.
Now that you are not gluing the stuff down, it's easier to remove and adjust them if you make any mistakes. So don't worry and go freehand. Now that we have secured our berries and flowers into the wreath base, it's time to add a bow. So I'm using a plaid wired green wreathspun for my wreath. You just need to fold it once from one end and the other. Twist it around to make a bow. It doesn't look much at first, but don't worry. We are going to fix it. Just pull on some ends. Make the center nice and then fluff your bow ends like this. You can cut the ends, just fold it in half and make a slanting cut. Now on the other end, now that the bow is ready, just take a little piece of twine, thread it to the back of the bow and tie it around the base. Just make sure that it is centered, because once you tie the thread, it will be a little difficult to move it around. Christmas tree wreath. For our Christmas tree wreath, we are using a grapevine wreath base, this snowy garland, Christmas lights, and a Christmas topper from last year's tree. For our first step, we have to wrap this garland around our wreath base. Once the wreath base is nice and covered, we need to create some diagonal lines. Once the garland is in place, it's time to add our lights. If you are using a bulky battery, you need to tie it in the back. Once everything is in place, add your Christmas tree star next to the twine where you will be hanging the lights.
pom-pom wreath for our Christmas decorations.
For our pom-pom Christmas wreath, we are using 3 different colors of yarn, white, red and green, a grapevine wreath base, some burlap ribbon for making a festive bow at the top, and of course scissors. Our first step is to make pom-poms. Take a yarn, loop it around your thumb and start making a skein around your palm. Once you have a thick enough skein, remove it from your hand and tie it around the middle. Make sure to tie it tightly. Once you have tied the skein in the middle, take your scissors and put it through one of the loops. Cut it nicely, find any stragglers in the middle and repeat the process on the other loop. This ball of yarn should be nice and fluffy, so we are going to cut the excess yarn on the outskirts. Fluff it to see if there are any longer strands of yarn and cut them. Now repeat the same process with your green and white yarn. Our next step is to glue our pom-poms onto the base. You can choose a pattern or go about it randomly. We had this burlap ribbon to make a bow, but on second thought, a bow might not be a best choice for this. So we are going to use it to create some patterns on our wreath. And there you have a cute pom-pom Christmas wreath.